I want to start now with the swaps is where we left off. I'm actually on page 375 in the curriculum. This all deals with swaps without the exchange of a notional principle. In other words, what we're going to do here is we're going to convert foreign cash receipts. We're addressing, if you're following me again with the Wiley material or the Kaplan-Schweizer or whatever else you're using, I'm addressing LOS 34F, which is to demonstrate how a firm can use a currency swap to convert a series of foreign cash receipts into domestic cash receipts. Now what's happening here is, let's say, and you can actually take a look at your screen right now, okay, because I have this problem up on the screen. Let's say I have a US firm, and and this US firm wishes to convert their semi-annual, and that's the key word there, keep a focus on the time frame, semi-annual cash flows of 8 million euros each to dollars upon receipts. So they're getting 8 million euros every 6 months, and they want to be able to immediately convert that to dollars upon receipt because it's a US firm. The exchange rate is currently 0.9 euros per dollar, and the swap rates in the United States and Europe, the swap rate in the United States is 4%, and the swap rate in the Eurozone is 5%. In order to obtain the swapped dollar cash flow, what we first have to do is we have to say, okay, all right, they're getting 8 million euros on a semi-annual basis. But what is the notional principle on those euros? In other words, they're getting $8 million on a semi-annual basis, and the interest rate in the Eurozone is 5%. We just said that. So in other words, the notional principle times 5% on a semi-annual basis has to equal 8 million euros. So what notional principle, what would have to be the value of the bond in euros, if you want to look at it that way? What would have to be the notional principle on the euros? Then when we multiply by 5%, which is an annual amount, so we de-annualize it by dividing it by 2, would equal 8 million euros on a semi-annual basis. Well, if we do that, we would come up with 320 million euros. Just do the math. Just solve for the notional principle. Again, this is just math. 320 million euros times 5% divided by 2 would give you 8 million euros. Now, here's the thing. Now that I have the 320 million euros, which is sort of this principle about this notional principle for the euros, then I want to be able to convert to dollars. So what's the next thing I have to do? I have to take this notional principle of 320 million euros and convert it at the current exchange rate of 0.9. You were told 0.9 euros per dollar. And if I take that 320 million euros and I multiply by 0.9 and I divide it by 0.9 euros per dollar, I wouldn't multiply. Why wouldn't I multiply? Why would I take the 320 million euros and multiply by 0.9 euros per dollar? Because I'd be multiplying euros by euros, and euro times euro would be euro squared. And there's no such thing as a currency squared, so I'd be doing it wrong. You can't be left with a currency that says euro squared per dollar. You got to get rid of the euros there so that you can get dollars. So you take the 320 million euros, you would divide it, as you can see from the math on the screen there, by 0.9 euros per dollar, and you would get 355,555,555. That would be the notional principle of the dollars, right? And then what I would do is I would take the 355,555,555 and then come up with the semi-annual cash flows, assuming an interest rate that we said of 4% in the US, so 0.04 divided by 2. And therefore, I would come up with a semi-annual dollar cash flow of 7,111,111. So the swap, therefore, would then allow the firm to exchange its 8 million euros on a semi-annual basis, that inflow, for $7,111,111. That's what we'd have. And why do we call this a swap without the exchange of notional principle? Because there's no actual notional principle. We're just saying, okay, what would we have to do in order to be able, what kind of swap would we have to create in order to immediately exchange those 8 million euros on a semi-annual basis into what? Into $7,111,111. That's what we're doing here with converting these foreign cash receipts. And actually, believe it or not, the reason why I've just spent time on this is because they've actually asked this question before on a level 3 exam within an item set. So be aware of that.